that was playing the part of a dumb person, but actually he was the most educated, the most enlightened person. But he did not reveal himself in that way. He wanted to remain unrecognized so that he did not get involved in material life. He was able to get away from his family because his family thought he's very stupid, so he's not useful for our family. So he was able to leave home without any difficulty. But when he was wandering, he got recruited by one king who needed someone to help carry his palanquin. The king only had three people to carry the palanquin. He needed a fourth person. So they saw Jat Bharat and they thought he would be suitable. They thought this Jat Bharat, he is very strong, he's a good strong build. He must be a good sudra. Carrying a palanquin is the work of sudras. So they thought Jat Bharat, he's a sudra, he's got this big strong body, we'll use him, he can carry the king.
Jat Bharat, he has a strong body, his legs are very strong, so because he's a sudra, they think Jat Bharat, his body is very strong, just like a sudra.
He was wearing a Brahmin thread across his neck because he was born in a Brahmana family, but they saw his body was very dirty, so they thought maybe he's not really a Brahmin, he's maybe just a friend of a Brahmin. He's not an actual Brahmin, because Brahmins will be very clean, but Jat Bharat was always dirty. So Jat Bharat began to carry the palanquin, but he was very careful. He didn't want to step on any insects which were on the path. And this caused some disturbance to the other people who were trying to carry the palanquin, because he would walk at a different speed from all of them.
When Jat Bharat carried the palanquin, he carefully, to avoid any insects, to avoid any insects, to avoid any insects, to avoid any 这样就给其他的教父带来了打扰，因为他的步调和其他的教父不一致。So
the king got really angry because the king was being disturbed. He couldn't. The palanquin was being rocked around, and the king was inside the palanquin. He got disturbed. He got very angry, and he threatened to beat Jat Bharat.
国王就生气了，因为国王就是感到很不安。 他坐在这个摇摇晃晃的轿子里面，他就感到非常的生气，他就威胁要鞭打Jat Bharat。
And he spoke a lot of abuse and insulting words to Jatbarat. So Jatbarat, when he heard the king speak like this, and Jatbarat replied to the king, and Jatbarat counteracted all the words which the king had said and spoke about them in a very unusual way, which confused the king. The king, hearing Jatbarat speak, the king could understand Jatbarat was not the dumb person which he was pretending to be, but he was actually a great saintly person, enlightened in great knowledge. So the king became very apologetic, and he fell at the feet of Jatbarat and begged forgiveness for his offenses. And then he asked Jatbarat, kindly explain these words which you have said, because I can't understand what you mean. So Jatbarat is trying to he's explaining the meaning of the words of what he'd been telling the king. He's trying to explain it in more detail so the king can understand. So Jatbarat explains to the king that, you know, living entities appear in many different forms, and some living entities are moving and some are not moving. But we all come into existence, we remain for some time, and we are annihilated when the body is finished. And when the body is So when the body is finished, then at that time the body enters to the earth. It becomes like the earth, it becomes again dust or earth. So Jatbarat says to the king that actually we are all different transformations of this earth. Everything grows out of the earth, and when everything is annihilated, it goes back into the earth. So it's something like in Christianity, when they bury someone, then they say like that. They say, from dust you've come, from dust you're going back.
So
So within the body there's spirit, but the body itself is earth. This whole material world is the energy of the Supreme Lord. But people, because of illusion, people cannot understand that God is not different from the material world. This material world is just his different energies. So matter and spirit are all not different from the Supreme Lord. The material energy is Krishna's energy, but it's separated from him. Spiritual energy is also Krishna's energy, but it's not separated from him. And when the material energy is used in the service of the Supreme Lord, then it becomes spiritual energy. So we want to understand how these different energies are all Krishna's energy. There's nothing in this world which is not produced by the energy of Krishna. Just like we may have a pot to hold water, and the pot may be made from earth. So the pot came from the earth. It's just earth, but it's made in the form of a pot, and we use it to hold water. So if we study everything, material world, we see it all has its cause in Krishna. We don't need to study anything separate, we just need to study Krishna. If we understand Krishna, then we understand everything. So some people may say that we get different varieties coming from the earth itself. Just like in the ground, you get different kinds of weeds and different flowers, and different plants, so many different varieties of things grow out from the ground.
有人说各种各类的品种，它们都是来自于土壤，比如说有杂草、鲜花和植物，它们都是从土壤当中生长出来的。
So the universe which we see, it may appear to be like the truth, but actually it's not. It's only temporary. It's not eternal.
This
The earth is created by different atoms coming together, and these atoms are also not eternal. Some people think the atoms are the cause of the creation. But we don't agree. We say no, atoms, they cannot produce life. You need the spirit soul to produce life. Without the spiritual particle, there will be no life, just in atoms. So scientists, they don't understand the actual cause of the atoms, why they exist, how they exist, where they came from. The atoms are not the cause of the universe.
原子并非是这个宇宙的根源.
Because the atoms, they also have to come from somewhere. Where do they come from?
因为原子也一定是有出处的, 但是原子是从哪里,从何而来的呢?
So only less intelligent people will say that life comes from atoms. It's Krishna who is the real cause of everything. He is the cause of all the atoms. He is the cause of all the material energy. It all comes from him. It's only due to ignorance that people will present some other cause of creation. We see in this universe, we see so many different varieties. Some things are small, some things are very big, some things are very, very skinny, some things are very fat, some things are like a result, some other things are like the cause. So these things, actually, this is all, we imagine all this. This is not actually the truth. This is just our imagination, that we see it like that. We're seeing it in a relative way. Yeah, something's big, something's small, that's in relation to some other experience which we have. What we think is big and what we think is small. So the objects of the material world, they're all like, just like pots. And they're all made of the same thing, they're all made from the earth, but they are named in a different way.
物质世界的这些 些对象就好像陶罐一样，他们都是由泥土所造成的，只是给他们起了不同的名字而已。
We make them in different ways due to different time, different activities, mixture of different substances, so that they appear differently, but it's all just a combination of the same things.
根据时间，根据活动，根据不同的元素的组合，它们显得好像是不一样，但实际上呢，它们只是不同的组合而已。
It's all different. They're all created by combinations of the different elements of material nature.
它们只是物质自然元素的创造。
But different creation, different processes of creation result in different varieties, different elements, different objects.
由于不同的创造的这些程序不一样，所以就有各式各样的种类，还有各式各样的对象。
But people like to take credit for inventing something.
人们呢，就会为他们自己的创造就感到就居功自傲。
Actually, it's all done by the material nature, but they often give the credit to some scientist.
实际上，这些都是物质自然所构造的，但是有人却把它归功于科学家。
Yeah, we give the credit to some man, ordinary man, and actually the credit should go to God.
我们把它归功于某个普通人，但事实上呢，这些功劳应该归功于神。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says the same thing. He says, "Prakrite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvashaha ahankara vimud atma kartaham iti manyate." The bewildered spirit soul under the influence of the material energy thinks himself to be the doer of acts which are carried out by the material nature.
受到条件限制的困惑灵魂，他们认为这些活动是他们自己所做的，但实际上呢，这些活动全是物质自然所做的。
So we try to take the credit for all the different things which are created within the material world.
我们把物质世界这些创造呢，就归功于自己。
But these things are being created naturally by the material nature.
但是这一切都是由物质自然所创造出来的。
And material nature is just one energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
物质自然只是至尊人格神手的能量。
So it's Krishna who is the real cause behind this material world.
Krishna 是这个物质世界的背后的原因。
But out of ignorance, people think material energy, matter, is all coming from chemicals. Everything is coming from chemicals.
出于愚昧，人们认为物质自然，一些物质是来自于化学品。
It's actually Lord Vishnu who's behind the whole creation. He is the controller, doing everything.
是主 Vishnu, 他创造着一切，控制着一切。
It's the Supreme Lord who protects everyone and gives shelter to everyone. Nobody else.
是至尊 主保护着每一个人，每一个生物，庇护着每个生物，而没有任何别的能保护和庇护生物。
So the material nature is like it's protecting us. It's protecting us, giving us shelter, giving us protection. The material energy is there for our benefit, like a guardian, like somebody to protect us and give us shelter.
物质自然在那里保护着我们，给予我们庇护。这些物质的能量呢，实际上是为了给予我们的好处。他们就好像一个监督人、监护者，在保护我们。
And it's Lord Vishnu who is behind the material nature, and he is the controller of the material nature.
是主 Vishnu 在物质自然身后背后。
He is the cause of all the everything which is talked about in sounds. Everything is coming from him. Even the Brahman, everything, the spiritual Brahman is coming from him.
即便是灵性的梵光，也来源于 Vishnu。
All the universes are resting on the Brahma Jyoti, the light which comes from the body of the Lord.
所有的宇宙都栖息在流眼自主的身体的这个梵光当中。
So we see on all the planets.There are oceans, and there are hills, and there are different kingdoms.
We see there are different kinds of planets, oceans, mountains, kingdoms.
So the planets, they give shelter to all the living entities.
These planets give shelter to all the living entities.
And we're standing on the earth, but actually we're all depending on the potency of the Supreme Lord Krishna. We're thinking I'm standing on my own feet, but actually we're all dependent on the potency of the Supreme Lord.
这个是至尊主的能量，但是我们却觉得我们是站在自己的脚上，我们踏在自己的脚上面，但是实际上呢，我们在依赖着至尊主的能量。
So Jadbharat asks Maharaj Rahugana, "What is the ultimate truth? What is the highest truth?"
Jadbharat 就想问。Rahugana 国王，终极的真理是什么？最高的真理，至尊的真理是什么？
So Jadbharat answers for him. He asks the question, then he answers. He said, "The answer is that knowledge is the highest truth. Non-dual knowledge is the highest truth."
他问了这个问题，然后又回答了这个问题，他说：“知识是终极的真理，非二元性的知识是终极的真理。
It should not be contaminated by any material qualities.
它不应当被任何物质品质所污染。
It's all pervading.”And it's without beyond our imagination.
它遍透万事万物，超越我们的想象之外。
It's there in the form of Brahman. It's there also as Paramatma, known by the yogis, and it's also there as the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
曼梵存在在那里，也以瑜伽师所知道的 Paramatma 超灵而存在，也以至尊人的神手而存在。
So all the real scholars, people who really know, they know that the Supreme Person is Vasudev, and he is the cause of the Brahman and the Paramatma.
真正的学者们知道，至尊主他是 Vasudev, 是 Brahman, 也是 Paramatma.
The impersonal Brahman is just the bodily rays from the body of the Supreme Lord.
非人格的 Brahman 只是至尊主所流演出的光芒。
And the super soul is the expansion of the personality of Godhead.
超灵是至尊性格神手的扩展。
And the personality of Godhead means one who is full in all six opulences.
人格神手就意味着是充满六项富裕的人。
So those people who are actually in knowledge, they will surrender to Vasudev Krishna, knowing him to be the cause of all causes.
有知识的人会臣服Vasudeva, 知道 Vasudeva 是万缘之源。
So this realization comes very rarely, only to some fortunate souls to understand this.
这种觉悟是那些非常罕见的幸运的灵魂，他们才能明白这一点。
Sometimes people describe the Lord as impersonal Brahman, sometimes they describe him as Paramatma.
有时候人们描述他是非人格的 Brahman, 又有时候他们描述他是超灵 Paramatma.
So the Supreme Absolute Truth is actually Vasudev, Krishna. No difference between Krishna's body and Krishna's soul.
至尊的绝对的真理是 Vasudeva, 而 Krishna 的躯体和 Krishna 的灵魂没有区分。
So Krishna says, surrender to him. That means to surrender, if you surrender to Krishna within or without, it's no difference.
Krishna 说要向要臣服于他。
There's no difference between Krishna within, what's within Krishna, and what's outside of Krishna.
Krishna 的内在与 Krishna 的外在，二者之间没有区分。
We want to understand Krishna, you have to hear about Krishna from a qualified person.
要想理解 Krishna, 必须从一个有资格的人那里来聆听 Krishna.
Without hearing from the proper person, then we will never understand Krishna.
不从一个正确的人那里来聆听，我们永远不能理解 Krishna.
So we may wonder then, where am I going to get this proper knowledge? Who's going to give it to me?
我们可能会想我从哪里来获得这门正确的知识呢？谁能把这门正确知识赐予我呢？
So Jadbarat said, tells the king, he said, you have to take the dust from the feet of great devotees and smear it over your body.
Jadbarat 告诉国王，你必须要把伟大奉献者莲花足下的尘土，去拾取他莲花足下的尘土，把这尘土涂满你的全身。
Without doing that, you won't be able to understand the absolute truth.
如果你 样做就不能明白绝对真理。
It's not enough just to practice brahmachari, be celibate.
仅仅修习真守、禁欲还不够。
It's not enough to just follow the rules and regulations of household life.
仅仅遵守居士生活的规范原则还不够。
It's not enough to leave home and be a vanaprastha.
仅仅是离开家成为行脚僧 vanaprastha 也不够。
And it's not enough to just be a sannyasi. You may say, I'll take sannyasi. That's also not enough.
仅仅是做一名 sannyasi, 你会说，那我就去当一个 sannyasi 吧，那也不够。
And you may say, I will do austerity in the winter. I will put myself in the freezing cold water.
你可能说，我会在寒冷的冬季去苦行，把自己浸泡在冰水中。
And in the summer, I will build fires around me, and I will sit out in the hot sun.
而在炎炎的夏日，我会在四周身体的四周点起一堆火，就坐在烈日下面火当中。
But none of these processes are going to help you to understand the absolute truth.
上述的所有一切都不能帮助你理解绝对真理。
If you want to understand the absolute truth, you have to get the mercy of a great devotee.
要想理解绝对真理。必须获得伟大奉献者的仁慈。
So, real knowledge of transcendence has to come from the pure devotee.
真正的超然知识必定是来自纯粹奉献者。
It's not enough just to follow the Vedas.
仅仅遵守严守伟达经不够。
You have to go to a find out a pure devotee and get his mercy.
你必须要寻找一位纯粹的奉献者，获得这位纯粹奉献者的仁慈。
So sometimes materialistic people think they will do a lot of piety and they will do many good.Things, giving charity, but this is not going to help them understand the absolute truth.
物质主义者会认为他会想，他们可以去做虔诚活动，去做一些善举、布施，但是这不能帮他们明白绝对真理。
Brahmachari, good brahmachari, good householder, good vanaprastha, good sannyasi, it's not enough. You have to get the mercy of a great devotee.
成为一名优秀的真守生，优秀的居士，优秀的行 vanaprastha, 优秀的 sannyasi, 这一切都够。你必须要得到伟大奉献者的仁慈。
So who are the pure devotees? Who are these people?
那么谁是纯粹的奉献者？这些人是谁呢？
So Jadbarat says, when you're with pure devotees, they won't discuss any material subjects. They're not going to discuss politics or any sociology.
纯粹的奉，当你和纯粹扎巴拉特告诉他，你和纯粹奉献者在一起的时候，他们不会讨论政治，他们不会讨论社会学，他们只会讨论有关于主的体旨。
Their only business is to discuss the qualities, the forms, the pastimes of the Supreme Lord.
他们唯一讨论的是至尊。主的品质、形象、逍遥时光。
And if you get the association of these devotees and hear from them, hear regularly with great respect, then this can help you to get to understand the truth.
如果你能够得到他们这样的人的涟漪，从他那里聆听，有规律的聆听，对他们毕恭毕敬，这才能帮助你理解真理。
Even one may be a Mayavadi, and he may want to merge into the Maya, into the oneness. But if he gets association with a pure devotee, he can become attached to the service of Lord Vasudev.
即便是 Mayavadi 想融入到一当中，倘若他们得到了纯粹奉献者的涟漪，也会依恋对 Vasudev 的服务。
So by the association of the pure devotees, you will become attached to the service of the Supreme Lord.
随着纯粹奉献者的涟漪，一个人就会对于至尊主产生依恋。
Lord Chaitanya had discussed about the qualities of the pure devotees.
主 Chaitanya 讨论了纯粹奉献者的品质。
And he said, Gramya Varta na kahibe. One should not indulge in talking about the news of the material world.
主 Chaitanya 就说，人们不应该沉溺于讨论物质世界的新闻。
We'd say gramya katha or prajalpa, to talk nonsense, to talk mundane things. This is very bad.
We say, is gramya katha prajalpa, to 胡说八道。已经讨论的都是世俗的事物，这是非常糟糕的。
Rupa Goswami also described things which destroy devotional service, and one of them was prajalpa, nonsense talk.
Rupa Goswami 也讨论了不利于奉爱服务的事物，其中一项就是胡说八道。
So Gramya Kata, Gramya means the village, the talk of the village. You know, in the village, the women come together, ladies come together, and they will talk to each other. They will say, did you hear about this lady? Did you hear about that person? And they will talk this kind of news. This is the gossip of the village. This is all nonsense.
Gramya 的意思是村子。在村子里头呢，那些村子里的妇女，她们就会聚集在一起，她们就会说：“哎，你听说这件事了吗？你听说那个事情了吗？听说这个新闻了吗？”然后她们就在那里，就是在那里流言蜚语，说的都是一些没有意义的话。
So devotee, pure devotees, if we want to practice pure devotion, we don't want to get involved. We don't want to have that habit to talk mundane things.
纯粹的奉献者，如果他们做纯粹的奉献者，纯粹的奉献服务，他们就不会让自己卷入这些世俗事物。
So, it's a very important point in the life of a devotee to control the tongue and not to speak mundane things.
一个奉 践者的生活当中重要的一点就是要控制舌头，不去讨论世俗的话题。
So we want to develop the habit of hearing about Krishna, chanting the names of Krishna.
我们希望培养讨论 Krishna, 唱诵 Krishna 的习惯。
We don't want to waste our time talking unnecessarily politics or current events and news of the material world. It's all waste, useless waste of time.
We don't want to waste time talking unnecessarily politics or current events and news of the material world. It's all waste, useless waste of time.
We just want to serve Krishna.
只是想服务 Krishna.
So then Janbarat tells Maharaj Rahugan, he tells him, he said, you know, in my previous birth, I was known as Maharaj Bharat. I was a great king, had an empire. Maybe even King Rahugan may have even heard of Maharaj Bharat. I don't know. But it was, you know, before the king, Rahugana.So Jadbharat says, in my previous life, I was also a king, and I was Maharaj Bharat. But now you're thinking I'm your palanquin carrier.
Jadbharat 就对 Rahugana 国王说，我的前生是 Maharaj Bharat. 我拥有一个伟大的帝国，我是伟大的国王。也许你没有听说过在你之前有这样的一个国王，但你并不理解，在此之前呢，我也是国王，但是现在呢，我却成为了你的教父。
And so, Janbharat says, I had achieved perfection. I became detached from all material activities.And I understood the Vedas. I even studied the Vedas and understood them.
我已经达到了完美，完全不依附任何物质的活动。我研习伟达经，透彻地理解了伟达经。
And I was engaged in the service of the Supreme Lord, but somehow I became.Over affectionate, I became very attached to this small deer, and that caused me to I neglected my spiritual duties.
我从事对至尊主的服务，但是我却对于一头小鹿产生了依恋和爱恋，因此我忽视了我的灵性职责。
And because of that.I had to take the body of a deer.
出于这个原因，我不得不投生为一头鹿。
So Jadbharat says this just after he had told the king about the importance of taking the dust from the feet of a devotee.
这番话之前，他刚刚对国王阐释了从伟大奉献者的莲花足下拾取尘土的重要性。
If we always remember the order of the spiritual master, then we'll never fall down.
倘若我们永远铭记灵性导师的命令的话，就永远不会堕落。
If we become foolish and try to take over the spiritual master's position, then we will immediately fall.
倘若我们变得愚蠢，试图占据灵性导师，超越灵性导师，占据灵性导师的位置，那样的话就会立即就堕落。
And if we think the spiritual master is an ordinary person,then we also cannot advance.
我们若是把灵性导师当作普 通人的话，也不会取得进步。
So Bharat Maharaj, he got a problem because he didn't consult a spiritual master.
Bharat Maharaj 之所以遇到这个问题，是因为他没有征询灵性导师的意见。
And he became attached to a deer, and he had to take the body of a deer.
他便依附于一头小鹿，结果呢，就不得不投生为鹿的身体。
But Jadbharat says that because in my past I did some sincere service for Krishna, so I could remember about my past life.While in the body of the deer.
Jadbharat 说，但是因为我在前世曾经服务了主 Krishna， 因此我能够记起我的前生，虽然我在一个鹿的身体当中。
And he said, I can remember my fall down, my past life, how I became a deer.So now I'm very careful not to mix with ordinary people.
因为我能记起我的堕落，所以我非常小心不和普通人混合在一起。
I'm afraid of their bad association, so I prefer to just be on my own and not to be with all these other people.
我害怕他们的不良联谊，因此我宁愿独处，也不愿意跟他们在一起。
So it was a big fall down for Bharat Maharaj because he had been a very advanced devotee, and then he had to become an animal.
对于 Bharat Maharaj 来说，是一个很大的堕落。因为他是一个非常进步的奉献者，结果却投生为一头动物。
But because he'd done some service, because he was sincere, although he made some mistakes, he was very sincere. So he got some benefit. He got the benefit of his devotional service.
Maharaj 曾经做了服务，所以他非常真诚。尽管他犯了错误，但是他也从服务当中得到了好处。
He didn't forget his position. He didn't forget that he's supposed to be a devotee.
他没有忘记自己的地位，没有忘记自己应该理应成为一名奉献者。
So in the body of the deer, he remembered about his fall down, and he was careful not to fall down again.
在鹿的躯体当中，他能够记起他自己的堕落，所以他非常小心，好使自己不再堕落。
And when he gave up the body of the deer, the next birth he took was in the family of a very pure Brahmana, so that he could continue his service to the Krishna.
在他放弃了鹿的躯体之后，他便能够投生在一个非常纯粹的 Brahmana 的家庭，好在他好继续他为主 Krishna 做服务。
So it's important to give up the association of worldly, materialistic people and associate with devotees.
所以非常重要的一点就是要放弃与世俗的物质主义者的联谊，而与奉献者们联谊。
Because from the devotees you get knowledge, that knowledge which you can get, you can...cut to pieces the illusion of material life.
因为从奉献者那里 能够获得知识，用这门知识便能斩断对物质生活的幻想。
And through association with devotees, we can get service to Krishna by hearing and chanting.
也正是由于跟奉献者联谊，我们才能有机会通过聆听、唱诵服务 Krishna。
And in this way, our Krishna consciousness will be awakened. And by becoming Krishna conscious, then we can go back to Godhead, even in this life.
就这样就能唤醒我们的 Krishna 知觉。通过 Krishna 知觉，我们甚至在此生也能够回归神手。
So one thing is to give up the association of ordinary people, and the other thing is to accept the association of devotees.
一方面是放僧人的联谊，另一方面是要与奉献者联谊。
With the association of devotees, then we develop our Krishna consciousness. And this association with devotees comes from the Krishna conscious movement.
通过和奉献者的联谊，我们便能发展 Krishna 知觉。而发展 Krishna 知觉是透过 Krishna 知觉运动而来的。
So this movement is meant for people who are serious about progressing in Krishna consciousness.
是为那些真诚的人准备的，为那些在想在 Krishna 知觉当中取得进步的人们准备的。
So that people can become pure devotees and go back to Godhead.
以便人们成为纯粹的奉献者，最终回归神手。
Okay, so we'll stop here tonight. Any questions?
我们染日帕布的问题，两个问题。第一个，感谢 Maharaj， 感谢翻译。加的 Parat 描述只有与纯粹的奉献者联谊和祝福，才能获得超然的知识。貌似他前两次的身世没有看到与纯粹奉献者的联谊，他的超然知识是怎么获得的呢？
What's that?
Jad Bharat said that only by association and with pure devotee and get lesson from them, one can get transcendental knowledge. But it seems that in his previous two births, he didn't have the association with pure devotees. So where his transcendental knowledge, where did he get his transcendental knowledge?
Well, he did get, before he retired to the Himalayas, he got a lot of association when he was the king. When he was the Maharaj, remember Maharaj Bharat was the son of Lord Rishabhdev, and Lord Rishabhdev was an incarnation of the personality of Godhead. And Lord Rishabhdev preached to his sons. We talked about that. We gave a whole class about Lord Rishabhdev's teachings to his sons. So Maharaj Bharat was there. So he got a lot of teaching from his father, who was an incarnation of God.
Rishabhdev 是人格神手的化身，他曾经对他的儿子们传教，给予他的儿子们教导，所以当他的父亲在教导他的儿子的时候呢，他也在那里聆听了。 我们有整整一好几节课都讲的是 Rishabhadev 的教导。
嗯。So he got that. He got it from Rishabhadev.
So these 超人知识是他从 Rishabhadev 那里获得的。
还有问题？
是的，第二个问题，他承认与奉献者联谊的重要性。可是书中没有描述加德巴拉特如何与奉献者联谊，据说解脱后纯粹后仍然要联谊，书中只谈到他如何避免不良联谊，没有描述他如何与奉献者联谊。
OK, well,
he acknowledged,
go ahead
He acknowledged the importance of an association with devotee, but there is no description how Jatbarat associated with devotee. It said that after liberation, after one become pure, one still has to associate, still need association. So there is only described how he avoid bad association.Didn't describe how associated with devotees.
But he's preaching to Maharaj Rahugan, so he's making Maharaj Rahugan a devotee.
他向 Maharaj Rahugan 传教了，他把 Rahugan 国王变成了奉献者。
He's giving him the right association to make him a devotee.
正确的联谊，把它变成了奉献者。
So that is how you sometimes to get association. Sometimes you have to preach to people. You have to make the people around you. You have to convince them of Krishna consciousness.
这就是为什么必须要传教，要说服别人成为 Krishna 之觉。
Of course, he waited for the proper time to preach. When Maharaj Rahugan was ready to hear, then Jatbarat started to preach to him.
当然，他是等待着时机。当 Rahugan 的国王已经做好聆听的准备的时候，他才向他传教。
Maharaj Rahugan, he was a good candidate for Krishna consciousness because he was going to the holy place. He was coming from a long, far away, and he was going all the way down to Ganga Sagar to Kapila Muni's ashram. So he was, you know, and he was going by palanquin. So, you know, he was a very good candidate, very sincere. He was actually a genuine candidate for spiritual knowledge.So Jatbarat enlightened him and made him a devotee.
Rahugan 的国王是一个成为 Krishna 之觉的非常好的候选人。当时他正是要去圣地，他走了他来自很远的地方，他要去Ganga Sagar Kapila Muni 的 Ashram。嗯，当时他是坐着轿子，那所以他是。获得灵性知识的非常真诚的这样的一个人选，所以他被 Jatbarat 的启迪成为了奉献者。
Yeah, you can't always just stay with the devotees. It's nice sometimes to be with devotees, but you can't always just stay with devotees. We have to go. We have to go in sannyasis.Renounced people, they go everywhere and they try to make people Krishna, to give Krishna consciousness to others. Prabhupada went to America alone. There were no devotees there. He went without association. Lord Chaitanya told the Brahmana in Kurmakshetra, wherever you go, whoever you meet, tell them about Krishna, and in this way become the spiritual master and save the world. You want more devotees, you want association, you have to be able to make devotees, bring people into Krishna consciousness. Prabhupada would want to know, how many books have you distributed? How many new devotees have you made? Haribol, you could not hear me? Guru Mani.
Hare Krishna. Good day, 我可以听到你，但是我 Guru Mani Madaji 那儿有点断续了，我们听不到他。是的， Guru Mani Madaji. Hare Krishna. Guru Mani Madaji. Haribol.
Tazai, right there.
Hare Krishna.
Tazai, Nali.
Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Okay.
Hare Krishna.
好，我们可以听到了。
Okay, Mara.
I don't know what I said now. I've forgotten it so long ago.
You said that Prabhupada wants to know how many books.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, okay. Did you translate that?
Yes, but I can translate again. Prabhupada 想知道派了多少书籍，想知道发展了多少新奉献者。
Yeah, our movement is meant to expand. It's meant to be a dynamic situation. We're meant to get more people. We're meant to grow.
我们的运动应该扩展，我们的运动应该充满力，应该有新人，应该不断的成长。
Sometimes we have to go to new towns, and sometimes we have to go to new people.
有时候我们要去一个新鲜的城市，我们需要去接触新的人。
We should always be thinking about how to expand Krishna consciousness.
我们应该总是想着该如何扩展 Krishna 知觉。
Okay, 还有问题吗？
是的，冉任帕布还有另外一个问题，Jet Bharat 获得的是 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 的神爱，还是 Vaikuntha 的神爱？
What did Jet Bharat attain? It's a Vrindavan's prema or Vaikuntha's prema?
Jet Bharat is a sadhana bhakta. So I don't think he would go to Vrindavan. I don't think he would go to, I think he would be in Vaikuntha.
Jet Bharat is a sadhana. 规范修行我不认为他会去Vrindavan。我认为他会去 Vaikuntha。
But it doesn't make much difference. It's the spiritual world. He's not in the. He went back to Godhead. He went back to the spiritual world.
但这两个也没有很大的区别，都是灵性世界。他回归神手了。他回到灵性世界了。
还有问题吗？Any other questions?
No
more questions. No.
没有。
对，我们现在没有看到更多的问题。
Okay.Okay, so maybe we'll stop here tonight then. All right? 我们
好的，亲爱的奉献者们，如果大家没有更多的问题，我们今天的课就到这里结束了，可以吗？大家还有问题吗？我们有一个问题，这是一位，我不知道那个名字是谁，顶拜亲爱的 Guru Day， 请问是不是规范修行回到 Vaikuntha？
Is that that by sadhana we return to Vaikuntha？
I would think it's usually by sadhana that we go to Vaikuntha. We have to, if you want to go to Vrindavan, there has to be that raga, that spontaneous mood of spontaneity, raga nuga bhakti, to go into Vrindavan.
我 sadhana 就是去的是 Vaikuntha， 要想去 Vrindavan 是需要很多的 raga， 就自发的奉爱 raga nuga bhakti。
But I don't mind to go to Vaikuntha. I'd be happy to go to Vaikuntha just to get out the material world. Can be very nice to go to the spiritual world to be with the Lord.Whether it's Vrindavan or Vaikuntha, it's perfection. You're back to Godhead, back to home. Don't look down on people from Vaikuntha.
只要离开了物质世界，我都会很快乐，都去了灵性世界，无论是去文达文还是百昆塔，都是完美的，回归了神手。不要瞧不起百昆塔。
Narada Muni is a Vaikuntha man.
Narada Muni is a Vaikuntha man.
He's a very great devotee. He's very dear to Lord Krishna. Okay. No more questions?
有的。昆德，迪维亚沙克提玛达吉，询问，如果我们这一世回不去灵性世界，精进灵修的情况下，下一世会不会投生为人呢？我做梦下一世是男人的躯体。要相信梦吗？谢谢。
Yeah, if your dreams are in relation to devotional service, then there's maybe some truth in it. Like if you dream about Krishna or the spiritual master, there may be some truth in it.
如果你的梦是跟奉献服务有关系的话，那么你的梦就是确实有一些真实性，比如说梦见 Krishna 或者是灵性导师。
That's good. Just like Prabhupada dreamed about his guru came to him, told him to take sannyas, like that he came several times to him in the dream, told him you have to take sannyas.
Prabhupada, 他就梦见他的 guru 来到他的梦里头，告诉他你要当托钵僧 sannyas， 有好几次都让他命令他当 sannyas。
What's the other part, the first part of the question?
Sati Mataji, 那是什么？
他是问，就是说，第一部分是，如果回不去灵性世界，精进灵修的情况下，是不是下一世可以投生为人？第二部分是做梦梦见自己下一世是一个男人的躯体，就是这个梦境，相信要相信这个梦境吗？
The first part is that if we can't go back to spiritual world, if we are very advanced in the next life, can we take birth as a human being?
Usually, yes, that's what happens. That in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes in chapter 6 about the fate of the unsuccessful yogi, one who does yoga but not yet fully perfect.
In the 佛家梵歌的第六章，主 Krishna 就描述那些不成功的瑜伽士的命运。
So Krishna describes two cases. First of all, one is practice yoga for a short time, but not perfectly. So when they give up the body, they go to the higher planets. They go up to the higher planets and they enjoy a lot of opulence there in the higher planets, and even sense gratification there. And then they will come back here and they will take birth in a very wealthy or aristocratic family so that quickly they can take up devotional service again.
灵修时间短的瑜伽师们，当他们还没有达到完美，就放弃了躯体，他们会在高等星宿上投生，在那里享受巨大的富裕和感官享乐。之后，他们会再次回来投生在富裕的家庭或者是贵族家庭。之后，在很短的时间内，他们就会再次从事Krishna之觉。
But if one has practiced yoga for a long time, but still not yet perfect, then they will take birth in the family of devotees, in a Vaishnava family. Just like Prabhupada and Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, they were both born in Vaishnava families.
但是另外一种情况就是经过很长时间的修习，仍然没有达到完美，他便会投生在奉献者或者是Vaishnava的家庭当中，就像Prabhupada和他灵隐导师Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur是投生在Vaishnava的家庭当中。So
to take birth in a Vaishnava family from birth, that's a very good birth. So the children born in our Krishna conscious movement are very important. We should understand that they must be very good souls, very pure souls, to take birth in a devotee family.
投生在Vaishnava的家庭当中，这种出生是非常珍贵的，所以在Krishna直觉运动当中出生的这些孩子们非常重要，他们有着非常好的出身。
So, you may be in a woman's body. Certainly, the man's body is a bit easier for self-realization. In the woman's body, it's not so convenient to practice Krishna consciousness like. You know, as men do, you know, which with renunciation, these kind of things, it's difficult in the woman's body. Of course, there are women pure devotees, but we see generally it's more men than women.
那么对于一个男人的躯体，有着男人躯体的人来说呢，自我觉悟要相对容易一些。因为就是修习Krishna知觉呢，对于妇女来说呢，她们气觉就不那么容易，不像男人那样子。当然我们Krishna知觉的妇女都是纯粹的。 但是男性呢，修习气绝要容易，有更多的气绝者，男性气绝者，相对于女性气绝来说呢，男性气绝者要多。But
we give equal position, equal right, men or women. But the male body or female body doesn't mean that you have the same kind of body in the spiritual world. 'Just because you're a man in this life doesn't mean that you'll be a man in the spiritual world. And just because you're in a woman's body in this world doesn't mean you have a woman's body in the spiritual world.
Okay, understand. So 并不等同于他们在灵性世界也有着同样的男性或者同样的女性躯体。
But it depends on the particular rasa, the mood of relationship which we're cultivating with the Lord.
是依赖于特定的 rasa, 我们培养与主的关系。
You should, although you may be in the woman's body, you should remember you're not the body, you're a soul living in a woman's body.
尽管您现在有一个女性的躯体，但是您是灵魂，是居住在这具躯体当中的灵魂。
So the soul in the spiritual world maybe in the male, maybe a male, maybe female. I don't know.
所以在灵性世界，这灵魂呢，也许是男性，也许是女性，我不知道。
But in the spiritual world, it doesn't make any difference. Men or women, they're all devotees, pure devotees.
然而在灵性世界，无论是 男人还是女人，没有区别，他们都是奉献者，都是纯粹的奉献者。
So we talk about, sometimes they say women are less intelligent. That means people, women who are not devotees.But devotee women are not less intelligent.
有这种说法，说女人不如男人有智慧，但是指的世俗的男女，对于奉献者女奉献者来说，并不存在这种女性不如男性有智慧这一说法这一种情况。
We have many wonderful lady devotees in Krishna consciousness.
在 Krishna 知觉当中，我们有许多奇妙的女奉献者。
And we've had women. We had a woman, one American woman. She went to Africa, and she sacrificed her life. She was killed by some African militant people.
我们有一位美国的女奉献者，她去非洲，她献出了她自己的生命，她被当地的非洲的军事武装力量就是杀害了。
And we know there are many highly intelligent lady devotees have written wonderful books on Krishna consciousness.
我们知道也有许多有高度智慧的女奉献者，她们撰写了 Krishna 知觉的书籍。
So women have an equal status to the men, just like in China, Nan Nu Ping Dang.
有同等的地位，就像在中国有这种说法，男女平等。
Okay, Hari Vamsa Das has a question.
我们下一个问题是仆人的问题，请问我们是不完美的，但是我们在做事情的时候总是想要做的尽善尽美。希望让每个人都满意，这个心态对吗？
We are imperfect, but when we are doing things, we want to do it perfectly. We want to satisfy everybody. Is this mood right?
We should want to satisfy Krishna and the spiritual master.
我们应当是想满足 让 Krishna 和灵性导师满意。
You will never satisfy everyone, but if you satisfy Krishna and the spiritual master, then that is very good.
你永远不会让每一个人感到满意，但是如果你能让 Krishna 和灵性导师满意的话，那就非常好。
Just like someone says, I am the servant of everyone. It's impossible. How can you be the servant of everyone? But if you are the servant of Krishna, then that is very good.
就像有的人说，我是每个人的仆人，那是不可能的。你怎么可能让每个成为每个人的仆人的呢？但是如果你成为 Krishna 的仆人，那是非常好的。
嗯，还有问题吗？
嗯，下一个问题 ，Harivansa 跑步，独自在一个城市里发展，奉献者发展很多的奉献者重要呢，还是与有很多奉献者？就是到其他的有很多奉献者的城市去联谊重要呢？近来去了西安、宝鸡、海口，感受到与奉献者联谊的甜美。
Harivansa Prabhu asked, so which is important to develop devotees in alone in a city?Or to associate with devotees, where in the city where many devotees. Recently, he went to Xi'an, Baoji, Haikou. He experienced the sweetness of a devotee association.
Well, if you have not developed any devotees in your own city, it's not very good. It does not speak very highly.That you've been staying in one city and you have not developed any people in Krishna consciousness. This is not a very good sign.
如果你在一个城市当中却没有这个城市却没有发展任何奉献者，这不是一个很好的迹象。
At least you have to make some attempt to try to do something. You're staying in a city, you're staying in some place, you have to try to do something to give Krishna consciousness to people there.
至少你应该努力去做事情。你停留在一个城市，你要努力去给予 Krishna 知觉。
All the other places, there's devotees, Haikou, Baoji, Xi'an, you go there, there's devotees. Why no devotees in your city?
您去其他的地方，宝鸡、西安，那里都有奉献者，为什么您那个地方没有奉献者呢？
Anyway.If you try and make some devotees there, then you get the credit. But if you don't do anything, then later on somebody else will come there. They will go there. They will get the credit.
倘若您在一个地方，那里就是您在那里发展的奉献者，那么就功劳就是归于您的了。但倘若呢，有别的奉献者来了。发展的奉献者，那么这个功劳就归于这个人了，就后来的这个人。
Okay.
Next. 好的，下一个问题，Chaitanya Charan Prabhu， 顶拜功德。Jadbharat 跟家人保持距离，不依附他们。这几天我父亲病重， 家人不断地联系我，我没有理会，但我知道他们肯定很难过，对他们的痛苦我也很难受。这种怜悯是依附吗？我应该怎么面对这一切呢？
Obvious Gurudev, Jagbharat keep himself away from his family members. He didn't attach to his family members. Recently, my father got very serious illness. My family members contacted me constantly. I ignored them, but I know they must be very sad.So I also felt very sorry for their pain. So is this a compassion, my attachment? So how should I face all this situation?
Well, you have to consider your relationship with the family. You have to consider, are you the eldest son? If you're not the eldest son, usually these matters are taken care of by the eldest son.
您要考虑，就是跟家人的关系，您是不是家里的长子？通常这类情况都是由家庭的长子来处理。
If you're here in India, it's not very easy for you to go there to China, back to China at this time. The time and circumstance doesn't make it possible. If you were in China, if you were somewhere in China, then it's not a big problem. But at this time you're here in India, how can you go back there? It's not so easy.
就是在印度，在这个时刻呢，在这种环境下呢，您也不可能回国。如果您在中国，那么就不是不成问题。可是您现在是在印度，
而且蔡天天上跑步说他是小儿子，不是长子。
So, I don't think it's a big problem.
我认为这对您来说不是个大问题。
You can pray. You can say, "I'm praying." You pray for his recovery. You do something to help or to get blessings to help him recover.
是 ，so he can say that to the family member, or he can actually pray.
Yeah, he can pray.Krishna to, or at least he can pray for the benefit of his father. He can say that if I have any pious activities from being a devotee, then please give the credit to my father.
您可以向 Krishna 祈祷，就是跟 Krishna 说，如果我做了虔诚活动，有任何功果的话，我把这些就是功果都给我的父亲，为他的好处祈祷。
Yeah. So that's a nice. You have the right. Then have the right attitude. You don't have any bad feelings or anything towards your family members. You wish the best for them, but at this particular time, it's not possible for you to go back there.
就这样的话，您就拥有了正确的心态，就是也不会对家人呢有任何不良的情绪，您就祝福了他们，而且在此时此刻，您是不可能回国的。
You may not like to tell your family where you are, just tell them that, but.Sometimes even if you start to talk to them, you start to tell them things, then it becomes more of a problem. So maybe you're better just to leave it as it is and just wait.
想告诉家人您现在确切的在哪个地方。嗯，而且呢，如果一旦您开口说话的话，嗯，那么就更麻烦了。所以您就最好是不理会他们，就等待着，等待。
好的，我们下一个问题吗？
啊，
下一个问题，胡人，女性可以进入气绝阶段吗？
Yes, internally, not externally. You can't renounce so much externally, but internally you can be renounced. You can't become a sannyasini, you cannot take sannyas, but internally you can detach yourself from material situations.To some extent, externally also you can renounce by proper dressing, by dressing in a renounced manner.
So, women can also dress as a renounced man, renounced woman.
Yes, they can dress as a renounced woman. In other words, they cover their entire body, they cover their hair, cover their head with cloth.And they may even cut their hair very short. They don't, you know, and they wear very simple, plain white cloth.
Okay. 就是可以把自己的头发剪得很短，然后就用很简朴的白色的，穿着简朴的白色的衣服，把自己的全身都裹起来。
And be very renounced in association. You don't associate with men.
在气绝方面，就是在联谊方面非常气绝，不与任何男子联谊。
And dedicate yourself, your time fully in devotional service.
全部的时间都奉献在都献给奉献服务。
But you should not be independent.
不应该独立。
You should be under the protection of some senior men.
年长的男性的保护之下。
Somebody who sees you like a mother and who can will protect you and make sure you're taken care of.
So, should be under the protection of some senior woman or senior man.
Well, should be there should be some men, really. A senior woman needs also to be protected. Women need to be protected, all women. Older women also need to be protected. It's a man who protects them, the man's job. So the man who is like a manager, who is like senior,So he has that, he should take that responsibility to protect the women.
下一个问题 Radha 甜品店请教 Guru 这一生在一起做奉爱服务的奉献者，下一生还会一起做奉爱服务吗？感谢 Guru Dev。 Hare Krishna。
Her question is that she did devotional service with some devotees. So in the next life, will they also be together to do devotional service?
Not necessarily, because they each have their own minds, their own thinkings. So it depends on the mind at the time of death. What is the consciousness of the mind will determine where they go.
不一定在一起，这取决于奉献者的心态，他们可能有各自的心态，各自的想法。在死亡时刻呢，他处在什么样的心态当中，他就会去到那里。
Just like two men may be together, and one man is thinking about his home, and his mother and his father, and the other man is thinking something else.
就像两个男人在一起，一个男子在想着他自己的家，他的父母，另外一个男子想着别的事情。
So, different consciousness. Although you're together, they will have different consciousness.
有不同的知觉，尽管你们在一起，但是有不同的知觉。
So the consciousness will determine where we go in the next life.
知觉将决定我们来生的目的地。
还有问题吗？
没有了，我这是最后一个问题。
OK。
好的，那今天我们就到这里了。非常感谢 Guru Dev 的讲课和回答的问题，也感谢 Guru Mataji 的翻译，感谢大家的聆听。我们今天就到这里了。
好 ，Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai。
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 那些好吗？让这 Ki Jai。